In this video, I will show you how to DIY a smart sound sensor using an ESP board like the one mini, ESP Home and Home Assistant. The total bill of materials is less than $4, which is cheaper than a good coffee or beer. So, cheers! With this DIY smart sensor, it will be possible to make home automations when sound is detected. So for example, you can extend your comfort zone and to use it to turn on some lights when you start talking or to play some music in the evening, or you can upgrade your security system and use it to detect sounds when someone tried to break in through crushing a window or a lock. The possibilities are endless once you have it working. And to have it working, you need few things like the one mini board. This board costs $2 to $3 and I will upload an ESP Home software on it, which will allow communication with a smart home hub like Home Assistant. Next thing that is needed is the actual sound sensor. The exact model that I'm using is KY037. There is also KY038 model that can be used as well, with no modifications. The only difference is that KY037 has a microphone with a higher sensitivity than the KY038. So depending of what you want to achieve, you can get one or the other. The cost of this sensor is around 50 to 60 cents. Three jumper wires will be also needed. I'm going to use female to male one and a micro USB cable to power on the D1 mini. Optionally, a USB power adapter may be needed if you don't have a free USB slot to power up the sensor. If you get the parts from AliExpress, they will be cheaper, but usually with way slower delivery times. And Amazon parts are more expensive, but usually arrive much faster. And that was the hardware needed. Next is the software requirements. In general, ESP Home dashboard is needed to upload the ESP Home firmware on the D1 Mini. The ESP Home dashboard is available as one-click install add-on inside Home Assistant. And Home Assistant is probably the best free smart home hub that you can have lately. If you don't have Home Assistant yet, or if you want to understand more about the different installation types, plus one stupid easy way to get started, then register for my Home Assistant webinar on my website. The registration is free and you can see the link on your screen, and it is also available in the video description. As summary, for the software part, a Home Assistant with add-on store and ESP Home dashboard are needed. And if you need more help with ESP Home installation, you can watch this video of mine. And if you need more help about Home Assistant, go and register for my webinar. Next thing is the wiring. You can use a breadboard to test the things up in advance, or you can directly solder the wires. Of course, if you have more than two hands, you can try to hold the wires during the ESP Home software upload. Anyways, here is how I wire everything. I connected the plus pin on the KY037 sound sensor to the 3-volt pin on the D1 mini. Then I connected the G pin on the sound sensor to the ground pin on the D1 mini. And finally, I connected the A0 pin on the KY037 sensor, that's the analog output, to the A0 pin on the D1 mini. When everything is connected, I just need one last connection, and that is simply a USB cable. I have to connect the D1 mini board to the device where Home Assistant and ESP Home dashboard are running. For that connection, I will use a regular micro USB cable. While I'm inside my Home Assistant, I'll press the C button to invoke the search command bar, and I'll start typing add-on. Then I'll select navigate add-on dashboard, and here I'll find my ESP Home dashboard, which is installed from the add-on store. Then I'll click on this open web UI button. And these are all of my current sensors that I have, but I'll create a new one by clicking on this new device button. I'll click continue on this dialog. Then I will name my new sensor, for example, sound sensor. Then I'll type my Wi-Fi name and password. I'll click next. I'll select ESP8266 here because my D1 mini is using such chip. And on this dialog, I'll click on Skip because I want to edit the configuration before the actual install. And here it is. This is my new sensor. I'll click on Edit button and I'll go to the last row and I will paste the following code. This code will enable the web server of this device on port 80 and will add few variables. Also, it will add three sensors. The DB sound sensor, that one, the volume sound ESP sensor and the raw sound ESP sensor, as well as one slider here. Of course, you can change the update interval, for example, let's say to 1 second or 5 seconds, it doesn't matter. All the credits for the ESPHome code are going to the Brenner Rubert from the Home Assistant community. I am not that smart to get out the DB sound, raw sound and volume sound sensor out of the KY037 device, as well as digital sensitivity slider that can be used instead of the physical knob on the device. After you already click save and then install. Now is the best time to double check that your D1 mini is connected to the device where Home Assistant and ESPHome dashboard are running. And then I'll select this plug into the computer running ESPHome dashboard. I'll pick the server port, which is auto-detected, and the installation will begin. After 5 minutes or so, the installation of ESPHome is now complete, and I can stop this installation. I can close this. The ESPHome software is now uploaded on my D1 mini and I can quickly test if everything is working as expected from the web interface that is enabled. And I can click on the visit button which will open the web interface of the device. And it seems that everything is working. These are the logs and this is the current state of the sound sensors. If I make a loud sound here, the state is changed. And if I decrease the sensitivity with this slider, and if I make loud sound again, the percentage is increased, but with a lower value, as well as the decibels. Great. Now, here comes the good part. I'll add the KY037 sensor that is attached to the D1 mini, or in other words, my smart sound sensor in Home Assistant, so I can start making home automations. But before I do that, let me know what is your potential use of case for this DIY smart sensor. For what exactly are you going to use it? Let me know in the comments below. And if I press the C button again to invoke this command search bar, and if I type integrations, I can select navigate integrations. And here in this list, I can find my sound sensor auto-discovered by Home Assistant. If that's not the case, you just have to add a new ESPHome integration from here and to enter the sound sensor name in the dialogs that will be shown. But I'll just click on Configure button, Submit, and my device is added in Home Assistant. Now, under my ESPHome section, I can find my sound sensor. If I click on it, I'll see one device with 5 entities and I can see exactly the same sensors, DB sound, raw sound and volume sound, as well as the sensitivity sound sensor. I can add these controls to my dashboard or I can make an automation. Time for a quick but useful demo automation inside Home Assistant. The automation will be the following. When louder sound or voice is detected, send a notification. I'll use this volume sound ESP for example. And I'll click on this plus button next to the automation section. And I'll select do something when sound sensor volume sound changes. And this will be my trigger. When this sensor goes above 0, for example, execute this action. The action will be call service. The service will be persistent notification create. And the message will be a loud sound is detected. For example, it doesn't matter. I'll copy this text and I'll click save. And I'll use the same name for the automation. I'll click save again. And my new automation is created. As you can see, while I'm talking, the trigger is activated. Trigger, that means the automation is also activated and the action is executed. And if I click on the notification section right here, I'll see my allowed sound is detected messages because my automation is working. Here is a challenge for you. If you manage to make this sensor, share the news to the world by typing hashtag soundsensoronowned in the comment section below. I promise to congratulate you personally for the effort. And if some of the terms and abbreviations that I'm using are not so clear for you, feel free to download my smart home glossary, which I made exactly for such cases. It is full of useful and simple explanations of the most common smart home and IoT words. And it is totally free. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'll see you next week. Meanwhile, here is some more DIY smart sensor videos from me. Bye!